Like, what did you make of Bynum's response? So obviously the first half of game three wasn't his best. He said he wasn't ready. He played well in the second half, and then last night, what did you make of the game four?
I thought he played well last night. You know, I thought he was engaged. I thought he did things well for us, not only offensively and scoring the ball when he got touches, but also defensively. And then for us, on the flip side, I thought we helped him a little bit more or a little bit better offensively by spacing the floor the right way so that he knows or knew where his outlets were when he got double teamed. He knew where his outlets were quicker than in the past.
Do you think you've gotten enough out of Ebanks and Barnes within their numbers, particularly Barnes,
What's your definition of enough? Is enough mean we're up 3-1, or does enough mean you're looking strictly at their stats and trying to compare them to LeBron's stats as a small forward for the Heat? So it's depending on what your definition of a small forward is. What enough is. We're up 3-1. So for me, we've gotten enough now. And again, it's a question that anybody would say, yeah, instead of Matt being 1-for-14 from the three, I'd love for him to be 14-for-14 from the three. You know, and I'd love for Ebanks to be averaging 12 points a game and be 5-for-6 from the field, just like he was, I think, in game one, every single game. So I think it's kind of it could be a loaded question in terms of that, because yeah, you want more. I want more from all my guys, but obviously they've done enough for us, whether it's rebounding, defending Gallinari, helping us in transition, or whatever. They've done enough to help us get to a point where we're 3-1 right now.